Coach Wooden was one in a billion as a coach, mentor, and friend. He had a magnificent obsession with caring, sharing, and giving to all. Coach made an indelible impression upon you, whether you knew him for 50 years or 5 minutes or 5 seconds. Coach would say so much in a few words, and his words stuck with you, continuing to inspire and uplift you. It was an incredible honor to become part of the basketball program here under Coach and be in a freshman class that included Bill Walton, Greg Lee, Vince Carson, Gary Franklin, and Hank Babcock, with upperclassmen Henry Bibby, Sidney Wicks, Curtis Rowe, Steve Patterson, Kenny Booker, and others. I'm so truly blessed and honored to have played for the coach and with those wonderful players, and to be part of a tradition that included so many other great players before and after me, and to have been touched by this man on and off the court. I remember one day after practice, early in the season, Coach called me aside to talk about how I shot the ball. Well, this was not a good sign to be singled out by the coach after practice. Coach was a real taskmaster when it came to practice. And so he had me go through my shot a few times visually, and he studied me and he watched me and he said, okay, Keith, I want you to go around the key and shoot shots and I'm gonna rebound for you. And I was just stunned that Coach Wooden was gonna be my personal rebounder. And so I shot the ball maybe 25, 30 times, and then he called me back over again. He said, now, how do you shoot that ball again? And I was like, I was getting frustrated, but I'm not gonna do that in front of the coach because, you know, you've seen me shoot the ball. I mean, what's the whole point of this? So we went through the whole thing again. Now, how do you start? How do you finish? Does it come off your fingertips? And he looked at me and he thought, and he said, okay, Keith, you're dismissed. He allowed me to be different. He made sure I was fundamentally sound, and he instilled in me the belief and the confidence to be the best that I could be and to be a success. I remember another time when I was drafted 11th pick in the first round by the Golden State Warriors. And a lot of reporters and media questioned whether I could withstand the physical rigors of the NBA. So they asked Coach Wooden. And Coach said something like, well, I'll tell you one thing, you never have to worry about Keith pulling a muscle because he doesn't have any muscles to pull. Coach had a way with words. On another occasion, I was out at the condo visiting with Coach, and I happened to mention I'd met a nice lady, and he looked at me, and that was interesting about Coach. You just started talking about things that were on your mind. You didn't really think about what you were saying. He said, oh, she's a nice lady. Is someone you might consider marrying? And I had been through a divorce a couple years earlier, and I said, oh, no, Coach, I don't think I'm ever getting married again. I just can't trust anybody. And he looked at me and thought about it, and he said, you know, Keith, Abraham Lincoln, my favorite American, once said that it's better to trust and be disappointed than to distrust and be miserable. And that was just a very crucial, important time in my life when he shared that. And this, just a few of my stories with him. We all have our own stories, and there's just the many different ways that he really touched you and made an impression on your life. As a mentor, he was never judgmental, never condescending. You could talk about anything, and he could be quite open and honest, always with a sense of humor. And as a friend, whenever you reached out to him, he always reached back, unconditionally. He always reached back, and he just had a delightful sense of humor and perspective about him. A Buddhist philosopher has said, to die a good death, one must lead a good life. Coach led a good life, and he died a good death. Coach led a Christian life, and he died a Christian death. And I know for many of us, with the sorrow and the deep feelings of grief we're going to experience, we have to think about one of the things he taught about balance and moderation, and let's balance that deep grief with the joy of having known this man, of the life that he lived, the love that he gave us all, the legacy he left. Thank you, Coach.